Welcome to Friday afternoon. It's pretty much sunset, dusk. This afternoon, I'm hanging out, brushing my hair. Thought I'd give you all a life update. Come hang out with me while I brush my hair. It's been a while. Needed to be done. My hair's super long now. So what's been going on? Hello. Oh, one more important thing. The mosquito coil. I have it. The mosquitoes have just been... Really, there's been a lot of mosquitoes lately, let me tell you. I don't know what's been going on. We had a long dry spell. Then we had some rain. I mean, it seems like things are pretty normal. It's just... Mosquitoes are very, very serious right now. So I've got my mosquito coil here. Most exciting news in my life is that tomorrow I'm going to Oahu. Now, I've never been to Oahu outside from connecting flights at the airport, so I'm really excited. I've heard a lot of things. I imagine it's quite different from the Big Island. For those of you who may not know, Oahu is the city where Honolulu is. It's got something like 1 million people on the island. We live on the Big Island, a rural area, and I think there's something like 200,000 people on the Big Island total, and the landmass is like at least 3 times larger here. So we have way fewer people spread out over a way larger area. So, I'm looking forward to it. The occasion is unfortunately a sad one, but a friend of my friend, who lives next door to us, had an auntie who died. It's going to be a memorial celebration of life. She asked me if I would come with her. And our mutual friend paid for the tickets. So, it's just for the day. We're going in the morning, and we're gonna come back in the evening. But, she knows a lot of people there. She has her hula halau. And, hula halau is like your hula dance crew. Halau, similar to hale, I believe, which means house. But anyway, she has her hula halau there, and she said, I'm going to get to meet them all, meet a bunch of her relatives. I think it's going to be really cool. Never gone to Oahu before outside the airport, so we'll get to see what it's like. She even got me a sarong. She's going to show me how to wear it, so that she said so I'll fit in at the event. Because everyone else is going to be wearing Polynesian clothes, so gotta fit in. So I'm looking forward to it, to get up early, but that's okay. It's going to be weird to fly somewhere for 1 day and then fly back, but people do that around here. I mean, it's what, I think from here to Oahu, the flight is maybe like 1 hour? Might even be less. It's even closer to Maui. The Maui flights are like... half an hour. It's like you go up, they give you juice, you go back down. I actually like those flights a lot, because they're so fast. I wish all flights were that fast. So yeah, that's the main thing that's been going on. Today we had some sun, some rain. Yesterday was a rainy day. Been doing a lot of computer work. I just put a bunch of green onions into the ground that had been sitting in the water jar, rooting. We'll see if they take off. Green onions generally do pretty well here, so I'm hopeful. Although I had a few that I planted that died. I haven't been doing as much garden work as I'd like, partially because I've been focusing more on some programming work that we have. partially because I'm lazy. I'm working on it. Something I'm working on. It's really hard for me to work when it's super, work outside, when it's super sunny and hot. I get heat stroke pretty fast. And it gets sunny and hot pretty early too. Like by 9, 10 a.m. If it's sunny and hot. I think that's one of the reasons why people around here get up so early. The sun's also up really early in general, so that's another reason. Rain is good for the plants, though. What do we have that's in the garden right now? I mean, we have a lot of stuff. Actually, long beans are doing pretty well right now. Plenty of harvest of long beans. And when I say long, long. At least 1 foot long. And for those, you know, I like to save the seeds. So what I do is, when we're gonna use them, I kind of open the whole thing and pull all the seeds out, all the beans, right, they're beans, and then those go back in the ground so that we can have more. And then when we have all the long beans we want, we'll start eating more of the harvest beans. They're so good, let me tell you, you can eat them raw, but I like putting them in my ramens. I don't know if you know, but I like to do ramen, like very big ramens. Put a bunch of vegetables in there, put soy sauce, oil, some people put hot sauce. I put all the vegetables I can, like all the vegetables. Highly recommended. I don't know why people look down on ramen. I mean, I know why, but it's a shame. When we get hungry, we all eat the same food, the ramen noodle, as a wise philosopher once said. Things have been okay, though, otherwise. Pretty quiet. Tux the cat has caught 2 rats in the last week from under the house. First she caught a small one, and then she caught, like, big rat. She couldn't even eat the whole thing. It's disgusting. But we praised her, gave her a bunch of catnip. She rolled around in it. She's a cat. I think there's still more rats. Because it's like, how many rats? Like, there's never like a rat, right? Like, there's never like 2 rats. They live in families. So, I think there's more rats. But the thing about Tux is, once she kind of like figures out that there is a rat, she'll like stake on it. Like every night she'll be there. Not the whole night, and you know. She's still a cat, she'll like go to sleep eventually, but like she'll sit down there silently waiting in the darkness, like the terrifying creature that she is. She'll just sit there in the darkness waiting where she thinks they're gonna run across. And if she waits long enough and sits still and quietly long enough, those rats will make a mistake, and then it'll be end of rat. You can find little evidence of rat, like we have a little compost, not compost, a food scrap bucket. You know, you wake up in the morning, you go to put your banana peel in your food scrap little bucket, and you look, yesterday's banana peel that you put in it is now outside. Tux the cat doesn't eat banana peels. Geckos and lizards aren't gonna go in those in there and pull out a whole banana peel. One kind of creature that does that. The rat. Anyway, Chex is a good cat. Knock on wood. What else is new? Oh, I know. Oh my goodness. So, you know I like to do my Chinese style ink painting. I've been doing bamboos. And I've wanted to start putting titles on my pieces. So, in the sort of like Chinese ink tradition, the three elements of the painting are the picture, and like the stamp, right? Sometimes called the chop, or the artist's signature, in red, usually. And then there's usually some writing. And it can be the title, it can be poetry, it can be some other kind of writing. And because it's Chinese writing, or Japanese writing, Korean writing, it's calligraphy. So, you know, you can make it very beautiful, and like, these three elements are all artistic, right? They have aesthetic dimensions, and they add to the whole, to the unity of the piece. And so, I finally have a stamp, finally got a stamp pad, tried making my own stamp pad, don't recommend it. I made it out of a sponge in a plastic box, did not work, it got moldy. Anyway, so I finally bought a real stamp pad. Stamps look beautiful, but now I don't have any titles. So I was like, that's it, I gotta learn calligraphy. My first goal was to learn the word, the character for bamboo. I like the character for bamboo because it looks like two little bamboo trees to me. So I got a calligraphy book from the library. Thank you, Hilo Public Library. Oh my god. I started working on it last night. Oh my god. It's so hard. Each character is made up of these smaller subunits called radicals. So it's like a dot, a line, vertical line, horizontal line, there's hooks. And so the one for bamboo is made up of six pieces. And so it's six strokes for one character. Two of them are kind of the same, but the other ones are different, all different from each other. So I have to learn how to make each of those strokes, then combine them to make the stroke for bamboo. I started filling up a sheet with like teeny tiny little practice strokes. Boy howdy. Just want to write one character. One character. It was so hard. It's okay, I'll just keep practicing. Little kids learn how to do it, so I'm sure I can. It's been hard for me with on the bamboo front. The more I practice, the more I feel like I don't know what I'm doing, the more unsure I am of every mark, the less happy I am with most of the work I produce. It's become very dispiriting, actually. I, like, don't even want to try. I'm just like, why am I getting worse at this? I know that it's complicated. It has to do with, like, you know, when you're first starting out, if you can get anything at all, you're happy with it, your standards go up. As you get better, you start to, as you get more experience looking at the type of art, and you get a feel for what looks good and what doesn't look good, and your standards just go up. Anyway, I know I'll keep working on it, I'll get back into it, and I'll be like, pew, 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 pew. It's gonna be great. It's getting dark out, I don't even know if I can be seen anymore. My hair is pretty much combed. Chili is probably nearly done, so this might be a good time to cut off. necessarily going live tonight. Let me show you around and then we'll finish. See you next time.